centre of the controversy surrounding the weekend's protests was New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian, who did try to stop the 30,000 strong crowd from gathering, but the courts allowed it to go ahead at the 11th hour. And she joins us now. Premier, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thanks, Ali.
Now, as we just heard there, you now have a problem on your hands. People are willing to defy you and the rules.
Oh, look, Ali, the community has worked together so well. All of us have made enormous sacrifices. People have worked years to build up a business or to plan ahead for things, have had to see those hopes and plans dash. And I for one, appreciate that deep sacrifice everybody has made to get to where we are. And I also say to people, there's not too much longer we need to wait before we get back normality in New South Wales. And I say that knowing that in the absence of a cure and a vaccine, we'll always have to have a level of social distancing, good hand hygiene, get tested, come forward and get tested with the milder symptoms. But outside of that, I'm hoping we'll be in a position that the New Zealand government and the New Zealand Prime Minister has found themselves in. From where we were to where we are today has been a huge achievement. And I say to everybody who's feeling that level of frustration, we get it, I get it. But please know that relief is around the corner. We're doing so well. And just as New South Wales was the first state to shut everything down, we want to be the first state that brings back the jobs and gets our economy back and running. And that's really important because we know that for people who've sacrificed so much, who are worried about their staff, worried about their own business, what the sacrifice has meant. And we don't want any further ranks. So we're moving as quickly as we can, even as early as today, there'll be further easing of restrictions. And hopefully in the near future, those organisations, those businesses feeling that level of frustration won't. And I just ask everybody to stay patient for a little while longer, not too longer. If we continue the way we are, if we keep coming forward to get tested, and that's the key, I'm deeply grateful for people, even over the long weekend, who came forward and get thousands and thousands of people came forward and got tested.
But Premier, I'm not sure people are willing to wait. I think the weekend changed everything. People have been doing the right thing, but when you can't have all of your family and friends at a funeral or at a wedding and you see those protests go ahead, it's changed the rules.
Oh, look, I think what it has done is highlight the frustration and turned into anger and up people feeling upset. I mean, I feel upset because all of us have worked hard to do the right thing. And I think, as I said yesterday, we do need to draw a line in the sand and move forward. But I will say this, that I deeply appreciate the frustration and also the huge sacrifice that so many people, individuals, organisations and businesses have made. But please know that we are working, probably if you look around the nation and look at how much each state has done, we've moved forward very quickly given our population and the number of cases we had.
Have the protests pushed back the next stage of easing restrictions?
Well, I think it's important to say that in New South Wales, part of the secret of our success has been relying on the data we get. So until this point in time, what's been really positive in New South Wales is even though activity has increased, we're moving around, we're doing essentially what we choose to do in a safe way, we haven't seen those number of cases increase, and that's a positive thing. And if that stays the case for the next little while, we'll continue to ease restrictions.
Well, you said more restrictions will be eased today. Which ones?
Oh, I can't tell. I've allowed some ministers to go out and make those announcements, Ali, so if you appreciate it, I don't want to steal their thunder. But
will we see fans at the footy this weekend?
No, not this weekend, no. But however, we have, as we've said, the use of corporate boxes and the like is the first stage of that engagement. But please know that we're looking forward to further easing restrictions, to bringing some level of normality back to our lives, but also really feeling more optimistic and hopeful about the future. I certainly am. And if we continue this way, I think all of us, including those businesses that are feeling that extra bit of frustration, can feel less pressure. But please know that the health advice is there for our safety. And in relation to weddings and other gatherings, unfortunately, in the past, they've been the main cause of many of the breakouts we've had. Because when you're in a close social environment, you forget, when you're at a celebration, you don't, and you're there with number of hours with people, it does, if there is someone with the virus, it does spread through that gathering. And we don't want to see that. However, having said that, I know the health advice is being updated as we speak because we have done well and we continue to do well in New South Wales.
Will you come down hard on those businesses that do breach the rules, that say do allow weddings to take place?
Look, Ali, our intention is for everybody to do the right thing because they want to. And certainly until this point in time, the business community has been absolutely fantastic in New South Wales. Yesterday, the Minister for Customer Service and I launched a new program we have where all businesses, depending on their industry, can have a checklist of what's COVID safe, and then they can get a sticker and display it in their business to show they followed the COVID safe guidelines. And that means everybody's doing things a bit differently. But all the businesses that have participated, I think we had 8,000 or 9,000 businesses that have already downloaded that checklist. The positive thing is everybody wants to protect their reputation. If you're proud of your business and you've done well, you want people to know that it's a safe place to come and eat or undertake an activity. And the way the business community has responded is so heartening and positive, and I'm deeply grateful for that. And we just ask everybody to please bear with us a little bit longer. Please keep forwarding and getting tested if you have the mildest symptoms. Relief is just around the corner. I'm talking just around the corner. So long as all of us keep sticking together. And I appreciate the level of frustration and even anger that people have experienced since the weekend, and I completely get that.
But are you going to ensure that no further protests take place?
Absolutely, and as you saw, we were the only state government that actually took the protest to court to have it deemed illegal. Unfortunately, the Court of Appeal overturned the initial decision, but of course, we don't, but not just in relation to that issue, in any issue, health orders are there for a reason, and it's only because we've stuck to them that we've done so well. If we'd just all abandoned that and hadn't stuck together, we wouldn't be in the position we are. I'm glad we're where we are, but I also know the level of frustration is growing.